All right.
So we're just going to start just closing our eyes down, having the arms nice and long, and just feel the palms are pressing back against the hips. And just watch that we're not kind of just locking into those knees, hyperextending them into your lower back. So just soften the knees. Close down your eyes and just take a little rock forwards and back through your toes and to your heels. Just notice where your body is today. Find that grounding, that reaching of the heels and the ball of the feet into the floor, and that lightness and length up through your spine. So find that midway point, maybe slightly more into the balls of the feet than the heels. And as you inhale, start to let the shoulders glide up, kissing your ears, and exhale, glide down. Notice how the roller will follow. Inhale to slide, exhale to roll it back down. Inhale, that's it. Just allowing our body just to settle down. Big toes down there, Lisa. There we go. Just know where your body feels today. So I really like to really honor Pilates in my sessions. Movement connection. And on your next exhale, keeping the width through your clavicles, start to nod your chin towards your chest and roll down through your spine. So you're going to keep pressing into the roller. So roll up towards your elbows, down to your shins. Yes, soften your knees when you need to. Inhale at the bottom. Exhale, as you roll back up, you roll up the roller into your palms, face back up on top of it. Inhale at the top. Exhale to roll down. Good. Find the longest curve. Feel that your body makes the curve of the roller. So let's get that feedback and that image in our dark mind. And as you roll up, slide the sacrum to the back of the heels and roll the way up. See if we can try and not walk through the hands, but like massage the roller down. And see, yeah, that is a lovely long curve. Let your head and dangle. And then roll back up. Feel that you massage through that roller to roll back up. Good, keeping that weight just slightly more into your toes as you roll down. Finding your body nice and flexible, like a slinky spring, going down the steps. And then rolling all the way up. Next time, we're going to roll down. You're going to allow the roller just to fall into your palms and take the prints up to the side. And then pick up your weights if they're close to you. And then roll back up with those weights. Feel the hang of the weights, the separation of your scapula. Don't worry about weights as well there, Lauren, because I forgot to tell you about the weights. And then reach those arms up to the ceiling. Keep the ribs soft and find the glide of your scapulas underneath your armpits. And then float the arms back down. Let's use an inhale if we can to float up without that little rib poke. And then exhale to come back down. So I just want you just to breathe into our armpits more. That's it, guys. It doesn't matter how advanced we become, we still need to start with a little bit of grounding. Allow the day, the morning, especially if you've all kind of worked this morning, all been busy. On the next one, we're gonna inhale, take those arms up. We don't need to have weights if we don't want to. And then reach over to the right. Let that left arm reach down. Now keep active through that left arm. Sorry, right arm reaches down. And then now turn the palm up and bring it back up. And then flip the palm down. Now active through that left side. Anchor down into that left heel. And just feel the freedom of that right arm opening up through your clavicles. Good. Last one. Now as you lift up that right arm, make it come up and over to the other side. And now open. Good, palm up to come up, spiral palm down. Anchor down into your right heel, soften your knees there, guys, especially the legs. Good, open up through your left right armpit there, Francesca. Oh, really up tight there. On that next one with that left arm, we're gonna reach it up. Good, and then we're just gonna go forward with the arms. Find a little hip hinge, a little squat here, or chair pose, whatever you wanna call it, and then come back up. Let's exhale into it. Get those weights by your ears. If you can, inhale back up. Remember, those weights can go down. You can even get half kilo ones at the back if you want. Let's reach the sit bones back behind you. And have that focus on that hip flexion. Okay, that nice pelvic hinge. Yeah, good. We're gonna stay down there. And let the arms swing back. Have a little break from the arms and then sweep them forward. and let the arms swing back. Good, sweep them forward, opening up your collarbones. Beautiful, guys, really good, long, neutral spines. Next time your arms go up, and you float your heels up, and then bring them back. And let's get a little ankle mobility now. There we go, good. Stay low, so as your heels lift, feel your sit bone spread more. Good. Like we're kind of doing our VMO on the reformer. Yeah, that's it. Good, guys. Watch your rolling in there, Francesca, of your feet. That's it. Feel the arches lift as you lower. Good.
What arches?
And then on the next one, let's come all the way up. Nice big reach. Arms out to the side. And we're going to lie down onto our back. So, yeah, short mats, be careful. We're going to take your foam roller, put it long ways underneath your sacrum. Okay, so we want to find a neutral pelvis when we do this. So I would lie on your back first, lift your hips up and place it underneath. Okay, shoulders down. Weights are going to be close to you as well. Good. Now, if your roller's too low, you're going to feel really tucked. If it's too high, you'll feel it's on your lumbar spine and too arched. And as we kind of release through your hips a bit, you might need to move that roller. So just go ahead and do it, okay? Weights in your hands and float those arms up to the ceiling. Good. And then find heaviness through the sacrum and heaviness in the coccyx, the foam the Y. Float your leg up into tabletop. And then float the other leg up into tabletop. Feel that nice heaviness of the femur bone back into the hip socket. And we're going to start to go into your toe tap femur arms. Inhale as you reach your right knee away. Find length through from the psoas. Exhale, feel the psoas pull you back in. Alternate sides. Now you may or may not touch the mat out in front of you. If you wish, you can add in that opposite arm floating over your head. Yeah, that's it. Then think about how we started when we were standing. The length through the spine, the ribs soft. So a lot of time we tend to pull our ribs in here. But allow your scaps to glide a little bit more. Allow your femur bone to glide and float out of your hip. And then everything joins back to center. You can always welcome to change your breath pattern to whatever you want, guys. You guys know what you're doing, so I want you just to do that. I'm just here to make you do it. I really started up this class because this is what I want, but then I realized I'm teaching it all the time and I don't get it. So someone else can start one up for me. Good, guys. And then now, if you wish, double. Take both toes away. They may or may not touch the ground, and then both toes back up. You may or may not allow those arms to float. If you want to change your breath into an exhale for more supportive as you float away and inhale to come back, you are welcome to. Floating out. Nice. Good. Lovely open hips there, guys. And then we're going to start to take your toes to the right corner of the mat. So knees together, just twist slightly in your femurs and both toes to the right. That's it. Oh, knees together, yeah. And then up we go. And then slightly to the left. Yes. So your femur bone's a little bit twisted together. And then you reach out. Now try and keep your equal weight. Oh, these are nice. Relax. I need more of the work coming from that hip. So find the hip dissociation and not so much the feet trying to do it. Lengthen out both sides of your waist there, guys. Arms can always come down if you need to at any time. Good. Last one each side. Nice, Francesca. Keeping heavy. Good. Bring your knees in. Give you a little hug. Remember, you can bring your arms down. I'm going to let you play around with whether you want arms up for challenge or arms down. Legs back up into tabletop and start to take the right leg out. Reach it long, left leg comes in towards you. Exhale, switch. So a little single leg stretch there, but switch them across each other. Switch and switch. Good. Use that roller to give you feedback if your pelvis is staying still. Watch that bracing, Annie. Soften. Good. Nice, guys. Feel like you're pushing that leg away from you, like you've got the strap around your foot. Nice. And then we go into bicycles. Start to reach one leg out, lower it down, cycle it in towards you, reach the other leg out. And keep going into that cycling, finding your length out through your waist. Beautiful. Is your cycling like you're on train tracks? Reverse your cycling for me. Good. Lovely. And then taking your legs up to the ceiling, nice and straight. Reach them as long as you can. Now right leg sort of reach down to the ground. Scissor those legs. Exhale, scissor. Good. Exhale, scissor. Good. Can you keep a bit more length through both sides of the waist, especially that leg that's towards you? Yeah, so feel that sit bone reach away more. Nice, guys. Lovely. And then you're going to bring your right knee into your chest. You can bring the weight down to the side. Hug that right knee. And slowly start to lower that left leg down to the ground. Now, if you're very tight through your hip, you can bend that left knee or keep it straight. But let's anchor the left side. Right leg goes up to the ceiling, straight. Arms can be down in a low V. And Miss Flexible, we're going to get back into your pelvis nice. So we're going to pull out through that right sit bone. We're going to inhale to go into your leg circles, go across your body. Exhale, circle out and around. So softening through your sternum, your ribs. You need to, I can bend your leg, yeah. And then it's going to be more like semicircles. Good, so I want more the hip stability as you circle. That's better. Okay, then forward, don't, listen to your body, guys, don't force it. If you're really tight in that left side, we'll do circles at the moment. We'll do a few roll downs just to get your spine going and then go. Change direction. Circle out and around. So feel like your femur bone is rolling deep inside the hip bone, but also feel that your foot is light floating away at the same time. Good. Last one there for me. Great. And then bring that right leg down to the ground. Lengthen it out as much as you can. Hold that left knee in. Have a little stretch there first. And use this stretch. Do you feel really tight through your hip bone, psoas and hip flexors? Find length there. And then maybe bend that right knee in or keep it down and anchored. Good. Take the left leg up to the ceiling. Circle it down and around. So if you've got your right leg straight, your left leg can go more like a circle. Or it might be like a semicircle. Good. Put the roll under your pelvis and just do a few little toe taps with your legs and tabletop until we're ready. And then change to the other side. Good, or the other direction, I should say. Finding length more. Good. Anchor down, Lisa, your right heel. Yeah, feel that support there. Yeah, there we go, there's support. Beautiful, last one there. And then bring both legs into tabletop, arms out into a low V, squeeze those legs together. For more challenge, arms can be up to the ceiling. And then we're just staying side to side. Take the knees over to the right. Good. Exhale back to center. Good. So we can take these arms nice and wide. Use this as a nice little massage. The roller may roll away a bit, so you might need to keep bringing it back. Or having it more as a bit of core control with your arms up to the ceiling, smaller movement, maybe even legs straight. Yeah, and you just tick-tock your legs from side to side. So nice to do a little bit different. What are you, do you normally do? Maybe change it up. Let's do one more each side. Feeling that lovely lumbar rotation and the connection from the inner thigh through your pelvic floor to your opposite oblique. Last one to the left, come back. Bring your feet down to the ground. Lift that booty up off from that roller. Slide your roller to your feet. So you're just going to slide down. So find your feet on top. But yeah, you can't do bridging without having the roller there. Now, pressing down. Let's just do a few rocks of the pelvis. Pubic bend to navel. Inhale, rock away. Exhale, rock towards you. Now, as you rock, can you limit any butt clenching that you have? So find that lovely release as you rock your pelvis. I like to forget about all our muscles a little bit sometimes, especially as instructors, we're so grippy. And then think that you're just a skeleton and your pelvis is just kind of rocking in the swell of the ocean forward and back. And see if that starts to get us into a bit more of a deeper connection. And then on your next exhale, you start to rock through that pelvis and bridge up. Reach the knees over your toes and anchor your feet down. And you can always do it without the roller. And then melt all the way down. Good. Then get those hamstrings working by pulling your feet in towards your butt as you go out. Yeah, that's it. Now pull them in, more pull them in. Pull your heels to bone there, Lisa. Pull that in. Yeah, you're pushing, yes. And then come all the way down. It is a killer on your hamstrings.
I like it.
Yeah, you're pushing out too much, Lisa, for your knees. You're not pulling in.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're really overworking the airway. So as much as your knees reach forward, you're counteract by pulling your heels back. So you get that more openness of the hip. Okay, and if your hips are really grippy, they won't want to open. So you have to keep thinking about it, that's better. Nice, guys. And then coming up. Good, hold it up there. Little pulses as we're up. Drop an inch, lift an inch, drop an inch, lift. Lift more there, Julia, get that booty working. Yes, that's better. Exhale, wrap your feet around that roller, John. There we go, good. For three more. Two, one, and melt all the way down. Just do without the roller as well there, if you need to. Inhale, we're coming up again. Exhale, if your feet are still on the roller, you've got a little point and flex of your feet. If you haven't got the roller, you've got heel lifts. So lift up and down, that's it. Go point and flex or heel lifts. Maybe stretch your hamstrings out if we need to. Good. There we go, two more. And then come all the way down. Lovely. Inhale at the bottom, we're getting tired. The rollers are starting to go away from everyone, that's totally fine. Bridging back up again, pressing down into your feet, lifting up. Take your right leg up into tabletop. Reach up to the ceiling nice and long, and then now lower that right leg straight out over the top of the roller. Inhale, lift it back up. Exhale to lower. Inhale to lift. Can you keep those hips really square for me? Three more on this side. Use your breath. Great, guys. And then lift up high. Bring that leg back down to the ground or roller, and then float your left leg up. Can your hips stay high? Reset if you need. And exhale, flex your foot, reach out. Inhale, point your toe, lift up. Good. How long can you get that leg without dropping that foot? At that hip, sorry. Two more. And then come all the way down. All right, lovely, guys. Pull that roller towards you and grab it for me. You're going to bring your roller up against your thighs, and you're going to take one of your weights and put it on your belly between your ASIS, so real low abs. It's just going to go a long ways. All right, so your legs are in tabletop, elbows are bent, so you've kind of got that little kind of pressure of the hands up against there. Good. And just notice where your weight is. Is it sinking down? I want to keep it sinking down in towards you. And as you exhale, I want the gentle pelvic tilt of your pubic bone to navel, feeling that the weight sinks, and inhale, release. Now, as you pelvic tilt, your knees shouldn't move towards you. Do you want a towel?
Yeah.
Good. You're bracing Annie. So you feel how your hip flexors are doing, yeah. Like crunching at it. Yeah, so it's smaller, it's less. Just allow it to sink in. Less is more for me. So find that gentle pelvic tilt in and release. Now feel that you just imprint your lower back into the mat. That weight is sinking in. Keep the weight sinking in and extend the right leg away from the roller. Left leg still pressing in, bringing it back. Exhale, pelvic floor. Oh wow, everyone feel a difference when they put the pelvic floor on? Everyone's weights just went, So think pelvic floor as you press out, good. So that weight is just giving you the feedback that if you're bracing. Okay, so feel the imprint and not the tuck. Beautiful, guys, so much better. And then, last one. Oh. Everyone found out? Because that would be lost over summer. Legs are straight, arms are straight. Weight can stay there to give you feedback if you wish. Now, legs and arms straight. You can have a little bent knee if you've got really super tight hammies. And now start to curl up head, neck and shoulders, round your thoracic spine, like the shape of the roller, and melt back down. Does that weight pop up? Let it sink. Remember, your pelvic floor, guys. Everyone did a good pelvic floor. So I'm two minds between cueing pelvic floor and not. Sometimes we need it, sometimes we brace. Good, so you've got such a good range. There we go. So we want to work into those weak muscles. And let's hold it up there. And now you've got your single straight leg lowers, holding it up, one leg down. And throw it back up. Your head can come down if you need to. Break whenever we need to. Lovely, guys. That's it. Is that weight popping up? Can you keep it down? Yes, Juliet. And come all the way back in. Oh. Right, now we can have a little break. Take the weight off. That's not what it feels. We got a few more abs. So take your roller now between your palms. So you're squeezing the end of your roller. Lengthen tailbone is length long and curl up into your chest lift and reach that roller out over your shins and then melt all the way back. And then curl up and reach. Hold it here. Now we go into double straight, double leg stretch. So we reach both legs and arms out. Exhale, draw it back in, tight little ball. Reach those arms by your ears and then try and reach the roller to your toes. Keep your spine in this position. Curl up, John, and stay up. Stay up with that head. That's better. Two more here. Reaching out long, coming back in. Your choice when you want to have a break. Coming back in, reach the left leg out, twist the roller to the right, crisscross, twist left. And I like to go upright with my roller to the side. And go upright with my rolling. Yes. Can you get those ribs to rotate to the opposite inner thigh? Are you rocking on your scapulars? Lift up off from them. I want to feel light underneath that bottom tip. Yes. And come all the way back down. Oh. You want to circle your knees towards you. Out and around. Told you it's hard. And then put your roller down by your butt. Roll the way down with your roller. Ankles on the roller. Arm hand weights to help you here in your roller. So inhale as you lift your head up. Reach that weight out towards your feet. And slowly curl all the way up into your roller. Inhale, grow nice and tall. Exhale to roll back down. Now as you roll back down, shoot your legs longer. There we go. Now, who likes to use their hip flexors to come up? Or overuse them, because obviously they're using a bit. That's it. Imagine that weight is sinking you back. Good, Francesca. They've improved. Lovely. Roll back down. Yeah, much better. Good, guys. Calming up. And it wouldn't really be an instructor's class without
100.
Roll back down. You can take the weights away. You can hold it up there, tips of the shoulders off. Gonna float one leg up, breathing in. And breathing out. Breathing in. Reach out long through that leg. That's better, Juliet. Switch those legs. Breathing in. Really nice. We've done a lot of abs. Breathing out. Good. That's it. And a bit lower with the leg and just curl more in the thoracic spine. Yeah. Both legs hover up or continue switching. Good. Who can get eye height with those legs?
I need stress.
Good. Two more there. Curl up more on your exhale. Lovely. Look at Kristen. He's got it. Best 100 in the house. Oh, and then come all the way down. Come up anyhow you want. Love you, roll up if you can. Otherwise, just come out any way you want. Bring that roller in behind your heels and your butt. Hug your knees tight. Good. Time for a massage of our spine. We're rolling like a ball. Inhale, let your head drop towards your knees. Lift your sit bones up to the ceiling and exhale. Keep that roller there. So try and resist that little flick of the heels up. Now where you've got the roller there, Lisa, that's in super easy mode. So let's bring it down lower to your heels.
I can't bend my knees.
Oh, you can't bend your knees? Okay, it goes back there.
Yeah.
I thought you just
cheated.
Now, as you've got that roll, take the arms out in front of you and see, can you still roll without holding on there? Inhale and exhale. Keep curled there, like a ball, guys. Nice and smooth. Find that lightness of the pelvic floor. These mats are a little bit held in, hey? Sorry. All right, last one there. And then we're just going to take the roller, cross your legs over, find your quadruped position. Now bring your eyes. If you want leg weights in the back, you know she's going to choose them. So we're just going to give ourselves a little shin massage while we're here. Just rolling it. Keeping your back quite low to give a bit of pressure. Good, guys. And then now let's bring shoulders over hands and have those knees underneath your hips. Let the feet flow up. Press into those hands, separate your shoulder blades. And as you roll the roller towards you, round your spine and try and bring your knees to your nose. Inhale to lengthen and even go into extension. So doing a cat stretch with a little extra outward. Inhale. So use your flexion of your spine to help lift your knees up to your nose. That's it. Let your head drop underneath you a little bit. Yeah, that's it, Francesca. Good. And feel the hips are light as you come in. So they lift as well. So you want to get, yeah, that's it, Federica. Inhale out. And if you wish, you can take one leg out behind you and curl in. And as you reach it out, you switch. Exhale, curl in. And then as you switch, you're neutral. Whew. Oh, so you might want to do it. Go three or four each leg. Go back to your double legs. You've got double legs if that's too much. You've got to keep those hips up high there, John. Pelvic floor will keep the legs up. Beautiful, Juliet. Beautiful. Okay, so we bring your knees forward and just have your ankles out and lift up nice and tall. Opening up the front of the hips. Arms out. If you want to have your weights in your hands, you're welcome to have weights in the hands. Thigh stretch here. So you're going to hinge from the knees, keeping your body in a lovely long straight line as you go back. And then exhale, come forward. The weights on this part is actually quite nice, but then they might get quite horrible later. So it's kind of like you can choose your poison. Good. When you hinge back, let's take our gaze, guys, out up the wall and up to the ceiling. And then the gaze comes all the way back in, opening up through the front of the hips. Now, having your feet up makes this a lot bigger stretch for your hip flexors. So if you want to take the roller away, Lisa, just take it away.
I'll just take it away.
All right.
It's ghastly, Lisa.
It's ghastly. Now, go back to where you like your little challenge point. Inhale, open, hug a tree, exhale. Inhale, open, hug a tree. And a bend in today. Beautiful, guys. If you want to challenge a little bit of that stability, open just one arm without any rotation and back it. Open up the other arm. Lovely, guys. Watch any rotation there. Lovely. Keeping those ribs to hips. Too much on there. Good. And then coming all the way up when you're even. Okay, and then just walk your feet forward and knees forward a bit more. So it's just your toes.
Bless you.
And give your ankles a bit of a stretch there. So what if you haven't got any good, very good knees, you might not like that.
Oh, I'm just jealous.
Just do some little heel raises there to get your ankles moving. And that feels quite nice to stretch out to the front of your feet there. Alright, so we're going to turn around and face me. That roller is going to stay on your right side. Just push it away a little bit. And you're welcome to have your left hand with one weight. Alright, and then you take your left leg out. You want to see where your roller is. Yeah, and then you might want to fold up your mats if you have
sensitive
knees. Reach the roller away. Lift the arm up to the ceiling. Now everyone, can we open up that right hip? If you're very tight in the hip, I'm happy for you to have a bit more of a lean into it. Ideally, let's try and get that femur break vertical. Take that arm up, reach up with your left leg. Feel like it's got a helium balloon on it to put a good correction for yourself, and then back down. Arm the weight down. Reach it up and reach it up. Now, find the, yeah, that's it, Annie. So you want to reach long through that leg. Beautiful. Can you get that leg up parallel with the bar? So you might see the bar in front in the mirror. See if that leg can come up parallel to it. That's it.
Good.
You're going good, actually, but just watch your pelvic alignment. So everyone lengthen their left adductor more and see how that goes. So think about lengthening the adductor. Yeah, you see how you get up a little bit further? Hold it up there. Good. And you're just going to take the leg back, take the arm forward, allow a little twist. Reach that leg forward, open up your chest. Can everyone lift up out of their shoulder a little bit more for that kneeling side kick? And just adding in little rotations, like a book opening and side kick. Beautiful.
Just checking my notes. I always put notes on this, otherwise I forget what I'm doing.
And then bring the leg down, take the arm over your head, and find a little lateral flexion. A little bit of a rainbow off to the side. Take the arm up to the ceiling. Reach out and lift up slowly, 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 and allow a side stretch. And bend that left knee in. Switch over your weights and your roller to the other side. So just see how you feel. This hip might be a bit different. Open up the front of the hip, nice and long. Push that roller away to where you feel you can go. Okay, and don't mind yourself leaning back a bit. Everyone looks good. Lengthen out through your right adductor. And then arm and leg down. Reach arm and leg out. Good. Arm and leg down. Good. And now for you, Lisa.
I want you to think about that oblique coming in to play more. That's it. And soften it. Yes, there we go. That's better.
Less is more, guys, isn't it?
More.
Good, everybody. Let's get that foot a little higher.
Come on, Chris, and you can get it up. Get it up, get it up.
Yes. Hold it up there. Keep it up high and reach the leg back. Arm goes forward. Good. Reach the leg up higher, higher, like a little helium balloon floating you up. Nice. Lovely. Feel that lift underneath that waist, underneath that left. Last one then, bring the leg down, have a nice side stretch there for me.
Oh, I've got some mermaid in later. Coming up soon. Be nice to do that. And then come all the way back in.
Good. All right, so keep the roller on that side. I'm going to lie down. So we're going to be on your forearm. So we're going to have our right elbow underneath. Now again, you might want to roll up the window side of your mat so you've got a little bit more. And when you either can challenge with feet stacked on top, or in a little bit tight with the mini rollers, you can tight rope. Like your feet. Now, everyone sink into the shoulder. Naughty shoulders, good shoulders, give yourself a lift. Now feel that lift. If you need your hand down to give you support, do it. Otherwise, out to the sides. And a sling underneath your side of your body. It's going to exhale, lift you up. Find that lift. Inhale to tap. Exhale, lift up again. Good. Yeah, let that arm help you if you wish. Lift it up. Now you're welcome to bend the bottom knee if you need to. Two more to lift up and down. And then that's hold that one up there. Hand behind your head. Exhale, rotate the upper body down to the ground. Push away with that right elbow and lift back up. Exhale, rotate. Good. Keep the hips square to knee as you rotate. Find those inner thighs. One more. Good. And then bend your knees in, find mermaid position. Or your other version of modification for mermaid as well. You can kick that left foot out in front if you need to. I reckon maybe Chris, a little bit tight in that hip. Yeah. Then your roller can come over to the other side. And here's the nice bit for you guys. We go over to your mermaid, so I join in with you.
Take a deep breath. Now, can we get more bend in your spine? Can you lift your right rib up into you and breathe into your left rib and then come back up? And again, just soften your sternum a bit, officer. Good, soften your right shoulder there for me, John. That's it, let it drop away from your ear. Good. So you're putting a bit more, too much weight on the arm. Feel like your waistline does the work more, better. And over we go, let's hold it there. Top arm, lovely twist through.
Feel thread the needle, inhale, open it.
And let's just use this just to calm up. Breath back into our body. Notice how it's feeling. One more rotation. And then all the way up. Keep the roller there, spin your legs around, and let's set up for your side lift on this side. Stack your feet or tie the rope your feet. Your choice. Fold up that mat double if you need to. And just have a little check where your shoulders are. Have a little sink lifter. I want to ideally get a vertical arm. Now, from there, that waist underneath you, lift you up, let your top arm swing you up if you can, and then come back down. Then swing up. Good. Can you keep that roller still? So as you exhale, come up, feel your right left elbow, left underneath leg, draw in towards each other. Good. Last two. Swing up, lift up, and back. Good. Staying up. Feel that lift underneath that bottom oblique. Hand behind the head. Core twists. Push away with that left elbow. Push, push, push away as you twist. Exhale. And then come all and then bringing that leg in. Yes, that's so much better. So feel like you're flying through the air.
And then we're going to hold it up there. And little pumps of those arms. Keeping your spine still, taking your gaze to the front of the mat. Exhale, get those arms higher and higher and higher. Good. Feel the retraction of your scapulas there. Good. And Ali, get more extension, please, for your upper back. Good. 3, 2, 1. Come all the way down. Turn your palms the other way. Feel even more retraction as you externally rotate. Gaze goes forward, come back up again. This time, straighten the legs. So they're still on the roller, but your legs are straight. So your legs are engaged, glutes are engaged. And then pump up from here as well. So really straight legs, active legs. Now as you pump, start to hover your legs up as well. And pump those arms up, lifting those legs up. Exhale, pump up. Good. Feel the back of your palms pumping up. So turn those arms more there. Good, guys. 3, 2, 1. Come all the way down. Relax your weight. Come up onto your forearms and find a nice supported extended position. Now, if you've got really tight hips, you might want to just kick the roller away, okay? So we want to lift up and lengthen those legs so we're really active. So we've got quite a lot of extension here. So if you feel a lot in your lumbar, just bring your legs off, okay? Lifting up, we're going to your single leg kick. Push into the arms, bend that right knee, 2 pulses. In, reach, lower. In. I want to hover off the roller as you reach. So it really, really gets that length through the legs without the hips lifting up. Now, if you're just here, you can do this all day. This is what clients do.
I don't get this exercise.
I want you to press into the arms. Find the length and the control. So we've got the psoas and the hip flexors really in eccentric control here. Lift up even more out of your shoulders. That's better. Active. Francesca, lift. Lift. There. She's like, dying. One more each side. Yeah, especially with those arms. All right, and then from here, come all the way down.
Hands slide under your ribs or shoulders. Legs long, really active legs like before. Press into the arms, oh, without bending your spine up into plank.
Beautiful.
And then bend the elbows lower, lower slowly down to the ground.
And then again, come up, bring those ribs into the body, press into the arms, come up. Oh, I'm so weak at the moment.
And then come in lower.
Lisa, you know how to modify this one? Easy peasy. Like yes. This. Bend those knees. Come on.
I'm full of injuries, sorry.
You can't do that either?
I'm full of them.
All right, you're going to go back to more dark ones.
Yeah, that's better.
Don't just wait there. Hold it up there, guys.
She's not letting me.
Hold it. Stay up there. Hold the roller still. Lift up the right leg 3 times. Lisa, go into some quadruped. You can do quadruped?
Yep.
Just do some quadruped. Lift up the other leg. And then come all the way down. Let's go lower your knees, actually. Let's do a child pose. Lisa, you're going to be doing some quadruped. Maybe adding, put your knees on the roller. And then you're going to do your opposite arm and leg slide with your knees on the roller.
Oh, I can't do those things.
So you can't do anything with that?
Nothing very deep. Torn extensive tendon and rheumatoid in my knees.
Okay.
The bed fixes them. It's like useless.
Okay, so I will get you.
4 pointers I can do for
you. Yeah. Okay, yeah, do that.
I'll just do it.
That's what I wanted you to do.
Yeah, like this, but yeah. Not on the roller.
Yeah, don't go on the roller. Cool. Alright guys, let's go back. We're going up into our leg pull front position. Here with the roller. Now get the roller more on your ankles and then start to articulate through your spine, pull your toes in and then roll back out. Okay? You might need to walk back a little bit. Actually, roll it more lower of your shin so then you've got more rest into your pipe. Scoop through the belly and lift up. That's it. Can you find your pelvic floor to lift you up into that handstand position? Last one. Okay, we're all going to come together because we're going to do a little nice bit of seated there. So just sit onto your roller. So sit up nice and tall, perched on your roller. grab your weights if you wish. Now, where's a lovely tall spine? Reach those legs out, arms out to the side. Find length through the scaps and also the clavicles. So not so much length that you squeeze and retract and reach out. And then rotate, watch your neighbor to the one side. Inhale back to center. Check in with your pelvis, is it moving? Is your legs moving? So do you want to open your legs a little bit wider? Flex your feet, nice and active. Keep those legs still. We shouldn't see them gliding. Let's try and get a little bit more grounding through the pelvis and just spar your ribs where you can. And going to the right, soar. Rotate, dive forward, press that weight back behind you. Good. Inhale to come up tall. Exhale, rotate, dive, land. Inhale, nice and tall. Good. Remember, pull back a little bit so we get a more thoracic flexion into that. You can take the roll away if you need to. Last one each side for me. You were right with inversions, everybody?
Yeah.
It's inversion time.
Terrible.
Okay. All right, just roll off that. So, where do I put the roll for this one?
Yeah.
I kind of gave you that cue by mistake. You were like, oh wow, that's I'll take it back.
Yeah. They're helping me.
Now, I want you to sink down a bit more, Julia, into a more thoracic flexion. That's it. Now, grab hold of that leg that comes into you. Go on, even if one hand. There. And then now grab hold. That's better. Good. Now, feel light off my leg now. Because you were, yeah, there we go. Because you were going too high up into inversion, too much on your neck.
Yeah.
That's it. Good job. Really pull that leg in.
Yeah.
And then slowly roll all the way down. Taking those legs out away from you, slowly to the ground. Straight legs, straight arms.
Oh, I'm not teetering now, are we?
Too much, you know, my life.
Engage
those legs. Float those arms to the ceiling. Still with your weights on, you know. Reach those legs out and reach up. Remember how the weights helped us? You can always put your weights in. Now start to slowly articulate away from your legs. Lengthening. You can bend your knees into an assisted teaser if you wish. Coming up again. Heel it up. Feel how light your feet and your head is. Lovely, and come back in. More reflection for me then, Francesca. So you're not in a V so much. You really get your upper back to curve. So reach towards your legs. That's better. Yeah, not so much open. Get that reach. That looks better. And legs higher.
So more flexion, not so much extension.
I don't want to go, I want this.
Yeah,
I want.
Yes, good.
We'll get into it. Yeah, like Kristen's got like perfect teaser. Hold it up. Slowing the legs, crossing the right over and left, and hug down to your knee. Boomerang. Let it flow. One real flow and articulation through your spine. So start to roll down through your spine. Arms come to the side. Flow up and over. Good. Switch those legs. Find your teaser. Little smile moment. Oh. And then come over again. Good. Start to roll down. Up and over. Lovely, guys. And let it flow. I want to feel that massage of active legs, really movable spine. Yeah, control it to get that little snapshot and teaser. Annie, little lady like opening. Yeah, you always like, woo! One more there. And then on your next one, can you cross over and find your standing position? Something that nice and tall. Your roller will just be behind you. Welcome for weights in the hands if you want something a little bit extra. Roll, have the roller lying on its side. And your right toe is just going to be on top of that roller. Weights in your hands. A space behind you.
Okay.
That's it. Grow taller, guys.
Take your best effort.
And then just find a little hip hinge. Sit down into your butt as you go. You might need to feel that roller pushes away from you a bit. And then come back up nice and tall. So fold into your hips. Think about how we started with both legs doing this. Wide for your sit bones. Might need to play around with where your roller's placed, if you can. And then you're going to hold it down there. Good. Have that tip of your toes on the roller. You're welcome to have it in the air. You're going to reach your legs straight, arms overhead, draw it back in. Think scooter on the reformer, guys. Reach it out. Really working your standing glute med. Sliding the roller forwards and back. Gliding the shoulder blades to allow those arms to come over your head. How much lower can we get into that scooter? Good. You're going to stay back there now. Whoops, I've lost my roller. Start to pivot around your pelvis. Lift the leg up and then come back tap. Lift the leg up and come back tap the roller. Lift the leg up and one more. And then come all the way in. One back. Other side. Go forward. And then just find a little squat, little hinge and back up. Spread your booty, spread your hips. That's it, fold into it. Think about those femur bones getting that lovely crease into the hip. and then get that nice low position. Maybe do get the roll a bit further away so then you can get down into that back front heel. Good, slide the leg out in it. Good. Can you get your knee on the back over your heels and take your weight back?
Yes.
And now slide it. Arms up over your head when you want, if you want, with or without weights. Slide it in. Not too pointy to your foot. You kind of have to relax your foot and get the movement more from the leg. And then hold it out there. Good, guys. Little pivot forward. Try and keep the arms out in line with your ears. Pivot forward, lift the leg up. So it's the leg that drives the movement, not the arms. The leg moves your pelvis forward and back. Good, guys. Come all the way up. Take a nice deep breath in. Stand wherever you like. You have the weights still if you've got them. And then, like at the beginning, start to nod your chin towards your chest and roll down through your spine. And if you've got the weights, allow your weights to really separate your shoulder blades. Soften your knees, your center of gravity slightly more on your toes. Let those weights dangle. But can you all lift your ribs up and your belly up and just a little bit, like you're going over the limbo pole. So release that. I want you to get, look in the mirror, see how little flexion you have. So see if you can, so don't go so low to get more flexion in your spine. And then roll the way back up again.
Just for the extension with me, right?
Your hamstrings are so long, loose and long, and weak. That's where I want you to go. I want you to pull back in all of your work. That's better. You need to find a little bit more lumbar flexion so you just don't hang into where we like to hang.
Good idea, because the thoracic is really tight.
Yeah, like you just kind of, you just hit like that, just that all your movement comes from there. You're just loading up the joints in the wrong way, as you can tell, because that's where all the injuries happen. So you need to change the way you move. You kind of, and like, it's that way you take the ego out and just go, I'm only going to go half my range. It's so much better for you. But it's hard.
It's good.
Because it's finding where it is. You don't really get it in our own bodies. So you can't see it.
Let those arms go to your chest.
Yeah. And then roll all the way up. Nice.
That looks better.
Oh, thank you. Right. Annie always runs away, but we're going to keep doing this rolling out on our rollers. And we're going to start with a little bit of back extension when we're ready. How'd you go, Lauren? See ya. I'll see if this works with the video. Got it. Oh. Yeah, I've got an hour on there.